Well, hello and a very warm welcome. It is Taekwondo time from the Wangjiang campus at the Sichuan University here in Chengdu in China. Time now for the women's team semi-final, the People's Republic of China. They will go against Poland. Kicking in the clinch. Team China landing nicely and continuously. 14 points there. Holding and kicking and holding a strong lead now. Good front leg up to the face there. Front legs landing nicely. Headshot just missing. The crowd absolutely loving it here. The feet flying. Nicola White doing well there. Step through back kick goal. No messing around. Lovely to see that. Big chop kick goal. That's a huge kick. Huge margin now, though, for China. But we're going to run down the clock now with the thin weights and the fly weights firing in the legs. What a fight it's been. And this has been an excellent contest, dominated by China. Poland superb. They will find themselves on the podium with a hard-fought bronze medal. Congratulations to them. Time now for the women's semi-final. The Republic of Korea, they go against Uzbekistan in this team contest. So the 5 points scoring straight away. No messing around from Uzbekistan. Fighter number 114, Feruza Sadikova, starting strongly for Korea. Fighter 146, Jo Hee-kyung. Back right tourniquet kick, well blocked. Plus the gam jump. Good strong stuff from Uzbekistan. Change of pace, there's a head kick not far away. Korea from being 15 points down at one stage. Now back to a 4 point game. Punching the way through, liked by the judges, makes it three. If Uzbekistan, yep, they will make the change. Good back leg turning kick, in fact front leg for Korea. Tries with the back kick as well. Good shots to the body, starting nicely. Back kick not far away there from Ozoda Sobranova. She's in red. Decent head kick, not too far away from the fighter in red. Still a 1 point game with just over a minute to go in this engrossing team semi-final. Uzbekistan firing forward. It's always the danger when you walk in, you can take one to the face. They're taking another power punch there. Uzbekistan's Madina Marabazolova. Well, this one's going right to the wire. Firouza Sadikova makes it a 4-point lead. That's why Korea decide to make the change. A clash of the front legs here. Im Gombyul changes stance. Back leg turning kick, well blocked there. Trying to change things up is Team Korea. 25 seconds to go. Uzbekistan looking very good value here. 2-point game. Sadikova will be replaced. This one for a spot in the final into the last 10 seconds or so. Jo Hee-kyung of Korea. Can she find an answer? The defensive work though on the inside from Uzbekistan. Killing the clock. Last 5 seconds. One shot could do it. Good counter. The referee gives the Gamjon for avoiding the fight there to Ozoda. Good push kick though from the Uzbek. Can she hang on in there? She's done enough in the last seconds for Uzbekistan to make it through. A huge performance for Uzbekistan. The emotion is evident. What wonderful scenes. Tough times for Korea. It will be bronze for them. The People's Republic of China going against Uzbekistan in the women's team final. So here we go. That to my eye is Firouza Sadikova. She's in red. We're back underway. Attempted head kick there. Good one from Sadikova. Gets three on the board. Uzbekistan starting strong. Now you have to fight for a minimum of 20 seconds. And then you can change, but changing upstairs again, another absolutely perfect head kick. And that's why the flag is flying for Team China. They want to bring in reinforcements. Song Ji. Can she be on Song? You bet she can. There's a headshot. There's no video review in this one. It does go up belatedly. And this time, Uzbekistan think, yep, enough of that. Let's get someone else in here. Yanglin Lee tries to drop one in. 16-7, the score's on the board. Conducted over a 5-minute round. Number 114, Firouza Sadikova. She's back on, she started so strong. I think she scored all the points so far. Well, the Uzbek State University of Physical Culture and Sport fighter steps in, Medina Mazibalova. Apology, it is still Sadikova, number 114. Hard to keep our eyes on this one. Keep your eyes on the scores though, 23-8. Ozoda Sobornova stepping in, what can she do? Brave enough. Back legs to the body, leaves a space to the head though. Still in this contest, don't want to settle for silver. Medina Mazibalova doing well, trying to get forward, trying to get some sort of scores on the board, hanging on for dear life to the protector. Good punch on the way through from the Uzbek, lands another. Fighting for it, full of energy. Well, at the halfway stage now. Back kick there. Good attempt for the 4-pointer. 4 points if you spin to the body. 5 if you spin to the head. And the referee unmoved there, letting things flow. That was a good back kick. Good little turning kicks in the inside. The fighting spirit plus the punch there for Uzbekistan. However, to the top left of your screen, Team China way out in the distance here. Well, the Great Wall of China is in Beijing, but this wall impossible to climb at the moment for Uzbekistan. 3 to the head there, absolutely perfect. Firouza Sadikova does well to take all of them. A minute to go. Sadikova, the team captain, so to speak, comes out, fights to the finish. 56-23. Well, they both eyeball each other as if to say, okay, will we fight or will we call it a day? They fought to the finish here at the FISU World University Games, graduating with honours. Is Team China deserve to be decorated with gold? Liu Zhonghong, Song Ji, Yang Junli, and Zhu Zhechi. Well, what a fantastic four they have proved to be. They take gold, silver for Uzbekistan, and that show of mutual respect comes into possession. Wonderful scenes for Team China. The Republic of Korea and Poland with bronze respectively, Uzbekistan with silver. But it's a fantastic four from China that take the women's team title. Congratulations to them. Time now for the first men's team semi-final, Iran against Kazakhstan. Good punch in the inside. Of course, the legs will be a little bit tired from the fighters. A few bumps and bruises. The adrenaline doesn't flow so well once you've finished competing, but a lovely twisting kick from Mirashim Hosseini. Plus one up to the head. The motivation for his team. Incredible from Mirashim Hosseini, just saying to his team, no, I'm going to stay out here. Must be feeling pretty fresh. Tried with a sandwich kick there. Takes one to the body, plus the cam jump for the push. Doing really well for his teammates there, just getting tangled up in the head guard. I wonder if there'll be a little nod. No harm done. Guess who's back? Mirashim back again. Mirashim the machine, Hosseini. Alireza Hozenpour working away. His head guard has come loose a little bit here. Wonder if the referee will spot it, letting loose with the kicks as his head guard comes fully loose now. Well, the chin strap was off. The head guard's gone off as well. If in doubt, bring out Mirashim Hosseini. Gets a head kick of his own there. Good back kick. Looking for the two extra points. 46-23 says the score. Regardless of the efforts here, the step-up chalk pick from Bezoltan Musakan can do nothing about Iran. Iran are too good and too strong. Well, basically, Mehran Bakhordadi and Mirashim Hosseini carried a lot of the weight there for their team. And they will make their way into the final. Good respect shown. An excellent tussle. Good effort, of course, by Kazakhstan. Well, the roar of the crowd will tell you that China are in the house. The men's team semi-final. Korea, the opposition. Yang Qiu for China. Working against Yi Sang-rol. Good little shot on the inside there from Yi Sang-rol to start proceedings. Yang Qiu, the taller of the two, but so far it's Yi Sang-rol with the lead for his team. Of course, the fighters can stay on for 20 seconds minimum, but for an unlimited time. As Korea add another five to the scores on the board, China decide to make that change. 6 points of a difference, the closest it's been for a while. Good spin kick there from the Chinese fighter, doesn't land. Does this time retrospectively go up, the 4 points added, plus the power punch. China in the lead for the first time, Courier responding. Lovely little twist kick in the inside from So Gongwu. So Gongwu back in again, trying to protect that lead. 39-27, a minute and 10. Spin kick attempted by the Korean, good punch from the Chinese fighter, lands, the chop kick misses. A minute to decide who's going into the men's final. Seven-point game. China bringing the power and powering a head kick onto the board. Four-point game, back leg turning kick from Korea. Excellent stuff, Lee Hung-yap does well to block. Reverse turning kick misses. The Gamjin will be given. Six-point game, last 30. Slipping and sliding in the centre. China firing back in, the big punch lands. Three-point game. Match management needed now. What energy have you got left? Both men fighting it out to a finish. China will make the change. So Gongwu will also exit. Well, the crowd have been ever present. Calls of Jai Yo will increase. The Gamjon will make it a 5-point game. Who can close out the show here? The battle of the front legs. Yi Sung-ral is on the mat for Korea. Shuai for China, trying to see things off. A 3-point game with 3 seconds to go. The reverse turning kick will make it a 2-point game with 2 seconds to go. Anil Gelassi gives the Gamjon. Have Korea given up the chance. The bottle of water has rolled onto the mat. They're slipping and sliding. I think they might need to clean that up first. Will they have a clean getaway? Waterway to finish. A second and a point. Anil Gelassi lets it flow. The water flows and Korea flow to the final. Unbelievable stuff, a wave of emotion. By 1 point does it, Korea overtake China in the men's semi-final. The men's team final now, the Islamic Republic of Iran against the Republic of Korea. And So Gongwu, oh, takes one straight up the stairs there, the Iranian. There's no video review card, but it doesn't score, very unfortunate. Unless you're Korea, of course. He'll find himself 4 points up. And So Gongwu took a bronze medal in the individuals. For Kodari likewise. A signal from Team Iran, they want a change. Mirashim Hosseini kicks one up to the face there. There's no video review in this one. Aryan Salimi turning on the power now. Lee Hung-yap doing well to block. 22-17. Korea still in the lead. Iran firing back though. Good spin kick. Hedge kick to boot there. Absolutely perfect from Korea. A change. So Gongwu concedes a head kick right on the buzzer there. Mehran Bakhordari. He's back. Can he put Iran back in business? The closest it's been as we go down the stretch here. ...35-27 into the last minute. A change for the Iranians. Here he comes again, Aryan Salimi. Can he sneak a head kick on the board? He goes for it. Forces the Gamjon, forces Iran back into this contest. 37-28. Reinforcements needed. It's the Korean heavyweight that we have chosen. Hanging on in there. They have to fight a minimum of 20 seconds. What has Salimi got left? Makes it a 7-point game. The clock ticking. 5-point game. Iran has never been closer to Korea. Mirashim Hosseini comes in. Jumping chop kick to the face. Gamjon Given. 6 points of a difference. And the whole go there of the Korean. Almost snapping off. Trying to snap out the reverse turning kick though. Goes for the win with the spin. But it's a miss. Well, the Korean team closing in victory. Big punch there. Can they close it out? Iran will make a change. They've been as close as 5 points of a difference. They're now 10 behind. Big jumping chop kick from Salimi. Trying to close things out is So Gong-woo from KNSU. Well, he's going to need all the help he can get because Arian Salimi's fighting to the finish here. The Iranian throwing big kicks. The Korean throwing the big blocks. The concentration evident on both faces. 50 to 37. Gives a little signal to his team to say, I'm fine, I'll continue. Mirashim Hosseini, can he finish with a flourish? Gets the 3-point head kick, loses it though. Maxim Goss, the Moldovan ref, takes the 3 points away, and Korea will take the title away. Iran have fought to the finish, but barring a knockout now, the closer trying to come forward, the clock running down. Mirashim Hosseini acknowledges it. Arian Salimi fires out the back kick, but a fantastic four from Korea. Here at the FISU World University Games, Lee Young-hak, Lee Sang-rol, Jin Ru, and So Gong-woo. Wonderful scenes for all four. After some fantastic fighting, confirmation, the Republic of Korea with gold, 52 to 40, they take the title. The Foundation Nation, Korea, they take the top of the table. The People's Republic of China with bronze, Kazakhstan likewise, the Islamic Republic of Iran with the silver medal. But it is the Republic of Korea taking that hard-fought gold.